Hello and welcome, viewers. As we know right now that the lockdown for India has been extended to the 3rd of May. This is something which will actually cause some jitters, at least on the sentimental front. But as of now, no major coming in on the equity side. Let's understand how and what is going to be the impact in terms of the currencies market. What are the kind of strategies you can adopt? We have Riya Singh, technical analyst currencies, joining us on the show. Riya, welcome to the show. Firstly, if you talk about the rupee as well, it's hit a record low almost at around 76.55 last week. Now, if you have to take these levels into consideration and the scenario that's panning out on the back of the impact of COVID-19, what do you make of this?
Yes, Hiran. Actually, it did do that, as we did see dollar index was near its peak last week. And of course, there was a lot of, concern on account of the fiscal slippage and the overall economic outlook. But if you look at the previous trading session and even today, where the rupee has actually recovered from the low and has continued the gains even in the today's session as well. So as compared to the last week, why this has happened was mainly because the greenback has been losing its strength against the the basket of currencies which is working in the favor of rupee right now. And also the recovery in the domestic market from the past few sessions is further supported the rupee gains that we are seeing in today and the last week sessions. So overall, we can see some recovery that might happen in the rupee in the today's session as well.
Right. And Riya, overall, do you think that the risk appetite is something which does remain, probably weak in these uncertainty times over the economic outlook? Because that's what majority of the traders, majority of the industry veterans have been talking about.
Yes, the risk appetite still remains the same because overall the COVID-19 risks is still there. We are still on the rise in that part. The uncertainty factor with respect to the fiscal slippage and overall economy outlook is still very high and very cloudy. We cannot say how it will pan out in the coming months or even for the year. The FIIs have still been the net sellers. The COVID-19 cases are still on the rise. And as you said, the lockdown period has been extended. So this all are, feeding in the uncertainty and the risk appetite. So but the investors can gain, confidence or support from the minutes that was released by the RBI. Because it revealed that the central bank are ready to use any instrument necessary to revive growth and preserve the financial stability. So this might help in the confidence of the investors in the money market.
Okay. And moving from the risk appetite as well. Now, if you talk about the Indian rupee, it's down almost around 6 to 7% versus the dollar this year. Mm-hmm. Now, the range has been pretty narrow. There is some bit of support that's coming in. However, there are domestic equity weakness that's also weighing in. Now, OPEC Plus cutting down production, again, that's providing some bit of sanity. If you have to take all of these factors into consideration and the ongoing situation with the kind of economic impact also that we could see, especially on the export front, where do you see the rupee headed from here if you have to take probably a 3 to 6 month perspective?
See, the OPEC that has happened, on Sunday, it is merely 10% of the overall production that they are doing. And the slump that the market has, the demand slump that is there is quite extensive because of the COVID-19 situation. So this 10% cut will not be very effective on the crude oil prices, for the rise of the price of the crude. But, it will have some restriction, or it will be, restricted to some extent. So there might not be much story there. So it will not play a very major role. in the rupee depreciation, because as we saw, it was actually vice versa that that was happening, where the crude oil was slumping and the rupee was depreciating. So it was quite a reverse scenario. So the OPEC cut will not have much of an effect. Yes, there is the weakness in domestic market is still there. It has not rebounded very well, but yes, there is some light on that part, as we can see the equity market will be gaining as well, because overall the VIX has come down, not only with respect to the equity market, but the overall VIX of the, you know, the trading part. So even in the currencies, the VIX has come down to quite, has stabilized from the highs. So we can see some profit taking that can happen in the rupee. So once it goes beyond 76, it can gain much against the dollar. We are seeing a level of around 75.50. But in the coming part, if there is the number does come down in the COVID-19 pandemic, and there is a stabilizing happening in the domestic equities, we can see rupee appreciating. But if that's not the case, then obviously the rupee can't depreciate much further towards 77.
For today's session, if you have to take these cues, what is the kind of strategy that you would advise?
Yeah, so for today, I think one can remain sell on the Indian rupee from the high highs, as it is consolidating within the range, but of 76.50-76. So from the high highs, one can go for a sell in today's session, as we can see a rupee gaining gaining against the dollar. So you can get a target of 76 to 75.85. JPY INR and pound INR will be on the buy side, especially pound, because the pound has been strengthening against the dollar on account of the PM now getting out of the intensive care. So that is some gains there. So pound INR will be on the buy side for the target of 96.25-96.30.
Right. All right, Riya. Pleasure speaking to you, and thank you for sharing those currency strategies for us for the day and for all the viewers. Thank you, everyone, for joining us on the show as well.